Hi, this is Will. It is morning time in New York City, and it is nighttime in the East. And I'm so excited to once again be joined by the amazing Chi Chen on translation. And we have the incredible Liu Jin joining us from Beijing, an acclaimed visual artist and director. Mr. Liu Jin, it is so nice to meet you. And I want to know from you first, when did you realize that you had a knack and a love for both visual art and film directing? And then from there, when did you actually start doing it all professionally?
刘老师，今天非常荣幸能采访到您，来自纽约的问候。他知道您是中国一位非常有名并且杰出的视觉艺术家和电影导演，所以他第一个问题是想知道，您发现您对艺术的热爱是从什么时候开始？
然后经历了怎样的过程能跟我们分享一下吗？这个应该是从很小的时候就热爱艺术。这一路走来呢，比较艰辛啊，比较艰辛。从小学艺术呢，我的家庭他是反对的，因为在中国的传统这个价值观里呢。 学艺术是没有出路的，对于这个未来这个从业就业，它是没有任何这个保障的但是我一直热爱坚持走到了今天。
您可以都讲完，对，我全部翻译不会因为网络影响而延迟。我刚才讲的是比较概括的一个，
你要让我去表达去说的话，这个。 可能需要需要时间，这里有很多的故事，很多的这个，就是从艺的这个过程，这个故事比较艰辛，因为我在我拿到这个大学录取通知书的时候呢，我的父母觉得呢，就说这也可以，就是。 这个能未来能得到一种保障，因为毕竟你读了大学嘛，在大学的这个几年里呢，因为我学的是工艺，工艺美术，就设计艺术，但是我最初呢，我的梦想是做一个画家，所以呢，就是特别喜欢想从事绘画这个职业，但进入大学以后呢，可能就说也不是我所理想的，读了这个大学。 但是呢，我可能在除了大学的课程之外，我个人的就是个人的努力，就是可能是跟学校这块呢，它是关系不是特别大。我毕业以后，我就是来到了北京，当时的梦想就是说想做一个职业，自由艺术家，所以来了北京，我就开始了。 所谓的这个比较风险的这个职业，因为它没有生活的这个生活的保障，生存的保障，然后就在北京租了一个房子就开始画画，然后跟画廊也建立了一个关系，所以比较辛苦，因为在90年代，在中国它其实是没有艺术市场的。 因为作为一个画家或者艺术家，你要为了生存，你靠卖出售你的作品，其实很难得到一个生活的保障。那这个时候呢，那个时期呢，我就是一边打工，一边坚持画画。我在大学里，在酒店里，都曾经工作过，直到我。 后来有了一个就是有一个画廊，一个欧洲的画廊签约以后，我才真正的就是摆，才真正做到相对自由吧，在创作上相对自由，作为一个艺术家，应该是在2002年吧，一直到走到今天，在这个过程呢，我的艺术创作呢也发生了很多的变化，从最初的。 这个对这个绘画，包括我后来从事摄影到行为艺术
包括现在我今天我开始就是开始涉足这个导演这个行业啊，导演这个行业，因为目前我在做一个电影项目啊。Well, it started out very young. Our Mr. Liu Jin was, he wanted to be a painter, but it's a torturous path because he faced objection from the parents. Back then, they believed that art cannot buy one bread, so they were worried about his livelihood if he really pursues his path. However, he didn't give up, and until he received an university offer, that's when he reconciled with his parents. His major was craftsmanship and design, and it's something that it's thought to probably can earn him a good livelihood afterwards. He said that the school, however, didn't really have a big influence on him. Later on, as he going to the society, he chose Beijing, where he became a freelancing artist. That was a very rosy dream, however risky. He rented a room and started painting and built relationship with some of the local galleries. And back in the 1990s, there's no market for art in China. So he had to work part-time while sustaining this kind of lifestyle. He worked in colleges, he worked in hotels. Eventually, and very luckily, he was commissioned by this European gallery. And that's when he started, when his career started to take off. Across the years, his expression had changed. And from art, it transits to photography, and then to performing art. And now he's going to direct his first movie. And that's a short history about Mr. Liu Jin.
Absolutely incredible. And I'm so inspired by you, Liu Jin, in that when you moved to Beijing, you just got a room and did it. You just did it. You didn't wait for anybody. You just did it. And that's what makes such a great artist an artist. And I also want to just affirm for you how beautiful it is that throughout your entire career, you've been able to combine your craftsmanship as a painter, a performance artist, a photographer, a sculptor, a video artist, and now going into directing. It seems like such a beautiful transition. And I want to know, with the projects that you've already done, including Wounded Angel, The Man with Glasses, and The Cruelty of Youth, if there were any backstories to the creation of those that you can maybe give us a little sneak peek about.
刘老师非常感谢您刚才很具体的讲解，他感觉到您是一个非常有行动力的艺术家，您想到去北京，然后就自己租了一个房子，开始了艺术生涯，所以这种勇气和行动力是他所钦佩的。
然后他接下来一个问题是，您跨越这么多领域的身份，然后尤其是在您后来很多有过展出的作品，比如说《受伤的天使》《戴眼镜的人》《青春残酷》等系列作品，能不能给我们分享一点当时创作时的故事？这个《青春残酷》这个是我在应该是在九十年代末期，九十年代末吧。 然后，这个作品呢，其实是跟当然由带有个人的经验啊，个人的这个青春的经验啊，生活青春的阅历啊，所以说呢，当你也知道九十年代中国开放到九十年代是一个非常这个有点就多元啊，对西方这个艺术思潮，其实是这个怎么说呢？ 在国内中国啊，就是影响是比较广泛的啊，这个时候呢，我结合自身的这个自身经验啊，尤其成长的经历啊，所以呢，包括结合我借助一个新闻啊，一个新闻这个载体，所以呢，我当时创造了一系列这个关于这个青春残酷啊，这个呢还有来源于呢我对当时。 这个还有一些电影艺术这块，当时我也阅读了很多关于这个青春，这个关于青春的电影，所以结合我自身的这个自身的一些这个生存经验 包括个体的这个生活啊，生活的这个经历，所以我当时就创作了这批这个关于青春残酷。之后呢，在变化的这个变化的过程中呢，可能而且当时在中国的这个现代化啊，又是城市化这个迅速的发展的过程中，所以呢，我基于还是我作为一个个体啊，个体这个对生存啊生活的这种感觉。 所以，我创造了这个关于受伤天使这个系列啊，其实它是对应的一个在现代化的中国，所以作为一个个体，一个个体这种经验吧，这个经验，这种经验呢是它是一种什么状态呢？它是一种受伤的一种啊，是一种被伤害的，或者是一种无所适从的，因为中国在近这个 20年、30年这种变化的速度是特别的，特别的迅啊，迅猛，特别的快，所以呢，让人有一种无所适从啊这种感觉，所以呢，我当时借助天使这个题材啊，就西方这个关于西方这个宗教啊，这个宗教包括这个天使里边的啊这样一个素材啊，来就是来呈现或者表达我对在当下中国这个现实啊。 这是现实的一个人类，或者是人类或者某一个我个体做一个生存的这样一个种感觉一种处境一种表达，完了这个之后呢，我走到了艺术呢，可能我是一个是从外在的啊，从一个现象啊，从现象走到一个内在的一个思考，因为我的作品始终是从青春残酷到其实呢，它是关注一个人的啊一个个体。 到肖像关于戴眼镜的人肖像系列啊，也是对人啊，就是做一个个体一个人的一个发问啊，一个思考。Thank
you so much. So well, it's a very good question. He would like to start by talking about the cruelty of youth. It was in the 1990s where he came up with that idea, and it's a work that expresses personal voice. And as you know, that time China had the economy reform, everything was changing fast and we experienced influence from the West. The art form of the West had come into China. And so he began to use the news as a medium and he watched movies about youth. Using that, he took his personal experience and put that into this piece of work. Then he would like to bring our attention to the Wounded Angel, which is the second piece of work. And it details his ideas, his thinkings on the gentrification and automation of the modern day China after the reform. There's huge change in the society. However, people feel confused and lost despite the material gain. He took Angel, a Western image, and trying to investigate how can modern people survive in the present China. And the third work, A Man with Glasses, is a portrait of a single person. So he transitioned from the society to a whole to individuals by that time.
Wonderful, wonderful. Well, already a plethora of work across all mediums. And I am so grateful, Liu Jin, so grateful to have spoken with you today. And I'm so excited that you're joining FENIX, where you're not only going to be able to have, you know, new people get to know who you are and your work, but also an opportunity for you to meet new collaborators in both the East and the West. And for all of that, I am so grateful for speaking with you today, and Chu Chen, thank you once again as well.
Digital age, artists and bands struggle to make a living. In fact, only a small number of artists can live off their craft. For the 98% of artists that don't have the luxury of being signed to a label, it's tough. But artists deserve to live off their art. Wherever you are around the world, appreciation of music does not change. FENIX brings bands and their fans together, whilst allowing bands to properly monetize their passion. The FENIX app will directly connect bands and fans with no need for middlemen. We're utilizing the blockchain to give the power back to the artists once and for all. Join FENIX, join the change.